Ladies and germs, sitting in front of you is the last Jolly Roger pirate kit in 1/12 scale from Lindberg. They've reissued them all over the past couple years. I have built every single pirate kit that comes out because I love pirate kits and ship kits. And this beauty, the Duel with Death, is the final one in the series from what I'm told. And now we're going to be moving on to the Haunted Mansion kits. But first, let's get the Duel with Death built up and show you what's in the box. You're going to have two rubber bands. Make sure you do not lose those. They are loose in the bag with the base. Speaking of the base, we've got our beach base here. We've got all kinds of tracks and gold coinage. We've got a space for a treasure chest. These are molded in glow-in-the-dark plastic, and they make for excellent little dioramas. Let's get all the rest of the glow-in-the-dark out here. We've got Mr. Pirate Man. Now, Mr. Pirate Man has some options. You can do a pirate face or skeleton. Now, I love the skeletons in the series, so that's probably the way I'm going to go. But the molding on here is always exquisite. We've got our actuation levers and our rubber band holders. We've got daggers. We've got cutlasses. Not the Oldsmobile kind, the ouchy stabby kind. We got the back of the figure. I love to hand paint these after priming them. You can leave yours glow in the dark or partially glow in the dark. We got the back of the heads for the skeleton or for the pirate himself. So it is cool accents on there. Let's get some more plastico out on the table. This one's got a lot of details, combining a lot of the coolest things from the previous kits. We've got a crab here, a giant sea crab, and we've got the top of his carapace there, and then he's got the two things to hold him on the base in place. I love when things rhyme. Excellent detail on there. We can shade that. We've even got a little diamond and pearl necklace to decorate and paint up. Get out your pearl colors, your metallics. We've got a shovel for digging the treasure up on the box art. We've got a lantern. We've got, it's stuck to the thing. We've got the other half of the lantern. We'll be able to detail those up. Get out all your craft paints and detailing. We've got a treasure chest full of coinage, pearls, necklaces. We got footprints in it. He's like, I'm not taking my treasure. Awesome. Treasure chest on the top. We get to detail all that. Brush it out. We even get to do the bottom, which is detailed of that cover because it sits open with him on it. Speaking of the skeleton who's standing in the treasure chest, got his pieces and parts right here. He's got more clothes on than most of the skeletons. Most of them have worn away in the series, but this guy's pretty well dressed for being decrepit and stuck on a small island fighting off another guy for the booty that he took forever, gave his life to find. Now we've got some extra parts there. We've got some small parts. We'll get everything out. We got the face on Mr. Skeleton. This glow-in-the-dark plastic is so slick. Check that out. It glows and it's slippery. We got more skull parts. We got shoesies. We got shoulders. We got more actuation levers. Both figures in this one move. We've got a cutlass in this hand. We've got a pistol in the other. We've got his pirate hat molded nice and thin. Awesome sauce. We've got a parrot for his shoulder. What else we got in this kit? We've got the medallions that they give you for free in each box, and the doubloon, and some extra pirate parts. Don't forget those. You get to decorate with those. And then we've got the other pirate hat and the pistol, the little flintlock pistol. Beautifully molded open. Those are all the parts. There are no decals in the kit, just those rubber bands and the parts themselves. I'm going to start slapping things together, and we'll be right back. Doesn't even take an hour of a little gluing and pressing together. We got our pirate scene set up. Now, I've got everything sort of pressed into base. There's one thing that goes into the base really nice. It's the shovel in this slit back here. But until I get some super glue on it, it won't hold. It just falls out. But you can see how it looks like that. That's going to be stuck in the sand. So that's a nice little diorama piece. We've got our medallions. You can assemble them if you wish. We got our doubloons. Check out my other reviews to see how those come out when you paint them and weather them. We got the pirate's hat and an extra pirate skull. We can put that anywhere. We don't have to use these accessory parts. We can save them, but his little hat will go on him there. He's got a little rod coming out of his skull, and it's got a little hole in it for us to line it up with. I've got his dagger right here. We'll be able to shove that through the hole in his hands when we're all got that already painted up and ready to go. We've got our extra skull, or we got our extra feet, hand, and bones. I always like to leave a little X somewhere with the bones on all my builds to signify that I've done them. And X marks the spot, so I always love that they include these extra parts. We've got the hat. Now, the hat is completely optional, no matter which skull you use, whether it's the man with skin or the skeleton head, but the hat can be placed on loosely and glued into place later, so I'll decide if I want to put it and paint it up and put it on. I probably will. We've got the nice parrot here glued together. That goes into a little hole on his shoulder to sit over his side and keep an eye on the booty. We've got the cute little crab with his carapace pressed on. He's got his rear legs here. Those are not sprues. Do not cut those off. I can grab this, get him sprayed, tinted, and painted, and then just clip those off later and cover up that area. We got the nice little lantern, which just drops into place. That's beautiful. We can hold it by its base and get that all painted. I love when they're set up like that. Then we come to the figures, and we're all set to go. So what we'll do is we'll reach behind him. His arm comes down when you press the button. And he hits his cutlass. And then if you move this lever on his back, he raises his pistol, and he wants to shoot. I'm gonna shoot ya. So you got the action working. Now I'll get paint on it. If it doesn't work after I get paint, I'll have to work on it, but you'll be able to tell. And we saw that it works. You see exactly how it works, but the base is absolutely lovely. We'll take each guy apart, take a look. We got him all ready to go. He's a handsome schmuck. This is glued solidly in place. This is your action motion here, where it just, you have this lever back here. We'll bring it down. We'll push that lever, and you see how it holds that arm in place. Then when you push it up, and his arm goes up with the loaded rubber band. So I haven't glued his shoes on. I'm going to paint those separately so I can get in there, and they lock into the base beautifully. He's ready to go. We're going to get all this stuff primed in black because it's a great base for figures and other things. We got the pearl and diamond necklace, which keys into the base with its own little peg there so it doesn't fall loose, but yet it can be its own individual piece. That's lovely. I like how they interlock all this stuff and plan it out. And then we've got our peg leg pirate, who's trying to steal the booty, and he's got a button actuator for his swad, so it just goes up like that, and then you just hold that button, and it'll keep going around if you have the rubber band twisted and he doesn't hit the other pirate's cutlass. So he is all set up. He is all glued together. He is a handsome feller, and I went with the skull face. I just like them better on these. I like the skeletons on there, so that looks awesome, and he clips into there like so. We've got our treasure chest in the base. We'll pull that loose. The two parts come apart so we can get them painted, but they just clip together like so, and then they press down into the base, so we'll be able to get all this stuff painted super easy. Now I'm going to head over to the paint area, get everything primed in black, then I'm going to pick some surface colors for my wood and my sand beach and the lobster or the crab. Come on over, see how I'm going to do that.
Rises way.
Well, now that I spent a little bit longer in this video covering how I do things, we'll take a look at stuff, and then all I've got to do is shade these guys out, the figures, and we will have our final. Now, when I talk about shading, I like to use these things called Army Painter Quick Shades. You can buy big packs of these. I know I make a lot of my own stuff, but there are some products that are definitely worth buying out in the field. Like this bone color, I use Army Painter Skeleton Bone. It just works great. It looks beautiful. It's got that old bone color from under the ground, and I like how it works. Same as I'll use Molotow pens for the chrome on smaller areas and stuff. Some things are just worth picking up. Well, a while ago, I picked up Army Painter Quick Shaders. They come in a large pack of like 11 for like 29 bucks. So they're, it's under $3 a little container, and these things last forever. They drop out little droplets. You put them on your palette a couple drops at a time. You use your eyeliner brushes to draw them in where you want them to be. And they come in all different types of colors. Like when I want to tint the blue on the figure here, I use the blue shader for the low points. The soft tone will work great around some of the bones. The strong tone will work great for doing the eye sockets and the nose and the teeth. We got a red tone for working on the red pants inside. We got a purple tone for working on the purple jacket. We got a green tone for working in his pants like that. They come in all different assortments and all different levels. They're super, super thin, and the pigments are really thin in them. So, you know, I just like using them. These were developed for minifig builders, and I love those minifigs from Reaper and all those companies, and I am getting the big paint assortment from them as well, and the shader assortment that I picked up years ago, and I swear each one of these has got to be 2 years old, and you know how much, I build over 104 kits a year, and they're still good, so don't worry about them running out. Sometimes it's worth spending a little money. Here's the base up close. Check out Mr. Crab. Looks awesome on there. We got our coins, and then I did that dry brushing over some of them to tone them down, but they're kind of scattered through there. We got that awesome lantern. Our shovel's in place, made it look like he's been shoveling sand with it. We got that nice necklace that I painted up with all the different colors and the metallics. And then we get the awesome treasure chest. And I took some Tamiya black wash and ran it in the footwells so it really looks like they're deep when I put his shoes in place. And that's going to look outstanding. Make sure you do all the way around the base, so you can see all the way around these things. It's going to look awesome. The figures are set to go with their weathering and their detailing and dry brushing. I faded the clothes. I beat them up. Now I just need to get in and do those toning. Same with the blue guy. He's ready to go. Just got to get him with those tones. The strong tone will work well to bring out the detail on his scabbard, whereas it's part of his hand now. And we've done all that detailing. We'll go into his eyes and his nose and his teeth and his mouth. I've got Mr. Parrot done back here. Pull him out. Then I shot him with a gloss clear coat, but from a distance. Hand painted him, made him look really cool. We'll use some tones on him to tone down the stark lines between the colors there. So all I got to do is get in there with those toners. Check out Mr. Skeleton's little shoes that I dry brushed, did the brass buckles on. We got the hats ready to go. A lot of dry brushing, lining around the outside, faded the pirate logo. Same with the pirate's hat. They used to be in the same pirate clan. And I've got a little backstory that I formulated in my head for that. Check out this little flintlock pistol. That looks awesome on there. So just having fun. These are two-day builds any day of the week. Do all my building and priming the first day. Do all my hand painting the second day. And because I use a lot of craft paints and acrylics like these army painters, they dry super fast and the craft paints dry with a heat gun. Everything goes together really nice. So I'm going to give everything its little tones and shades around there. Put them on the base and we'll be back for that final. It's been a long, fun road, and I'm sad to see it go. I wish they had dozens more of these pirate kits because they are just phenomenal. But here is the final, as far as I know, the final pirate kit from Lindberg. The original MPC kits being re-released under the Lindberg brand, the Jolly Roger series Duel with Death in 1/12 scale. An absolute stunner to end the series with. I love the giant treasure chest. We've got the two pirates. We've got the one pirate here, and he's trying to get the treasure from the pirate that's been guarding it forever. He's in a very dynamic action pose. He's got the chopping action. He's got the pistol action where he slings it up. It's hard for me to do it while it's on camera, so we're going to do it manually. But he's got the chopping action with his sword. He's got the action with his dueling action with his pistol. He's got his cutlass right there. We've got a shovel. We've got the treasure chest. We've got a lantern. I threw some extra skull and bones of the last guy that tried to get this guy's treasure. My backstory for it is he was hired by the king. His witch turned his head into a skull. If he wants his normal head back, he's got to go and recover the treasure from this pirate. The deal has been made with other ex-pirates before. You can see how well it went for this guy. You can see how well it went for the guy whose bones are used as the ex. The crab always picks all the bones clean once this guy's done slaughtering it. His parrot is all painted up. His parrot wants to pick some bones clean, so he's going to fight hard. He's got guns and cutlasses and a bloodstained cutlass from him killing other pirates back in the day. And he's got a flintlock pistol on his belt, and he's got his dagger at the ready. And he's got a peg leg. He had a bad day a few years ago. And he is ready to battle, and it is a lot of fun. And it's a beautiful base, and these all make such gorgeous dioramas that you can't go wrong picking these up. Now, round two was sweet enough to send this over. They've also sent over the most recent Haunted Mansion kits, so stay tuned for those because those are going to be the next series I'm building up. I've already done one and I've got some more in the pipe coming up. You can build these so easy and weather them up. You get these medallions and doubloons for free and you can collect them all with all the kits and you can have an excellent set of dioramas. Check out on my channel, if you go to the homepage and search Pirates, you'll see that all of these are on there, every single one from the beginning all the way till now, and we'll switch over to the Haunted Mansion kits now and build that series as it comes out as well. I love changing things up between figures and cars and boats and planes and tanks and armored vehicles and whatever, because modeling is fun no matter what. Decorate your pirates. Build them fresh like a cartoon. I've done a couple like cartoons. Build them weathered and beat up like they might be in a movie like this where they're all beat up. Just have fun, folks, and enjoy yourself with these kits. This will keep going around. There'll be still shots at the end of the video. As always, I will see all of you at the next review, and there will be links in the description where you can snatch up your Duel with Death from Lindberg. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.